isn't so bad because we can actually identify what the slope is and what the y-intercept is. Because you might say, well, there's no x, so how am I going to determine what my slope is? Well, we could always write this as y equals 0 times x minus 2. Because 0 times x is going to be 0. 0 minus 2 is still negative 2, right? But that still might not help you if you don't understand what the slope, what a 0 slope is going to, how you're going to graph that. So the best way I like to explain vertical and horizontal lines, which we're going to do over and over again in this class, is to use a table of values. When you guys first learned how to graph, we talked about using table of values. Now in this equation, we know that y is equal to negative 2, right? Now remember, a line is an infinite many set of points, right? Points make up a line from your geometry class. So the only thing we know is y equals negative 2. And our x values, those could be arbitrary values. So if here's our x-axis, here's our y-axis, we know that y always equals negative 2. Well, let's pick some x values that just for fun. Let's pick, oh, y value's down here, right? So y equals negative 2. Let's pick x equals negative 5, negative 2, 0, 3, and 4. Well, when x equals negative 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, y equals negative 2. When x equals negative 2, y equals negative 2. X equals 0, y equals negative 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it doesn't matter what the x value is, y always equals negative 2. So hopefully what you guys can see is these, when you connect these points, they are going to create a horizontal line. So when y equals a value, that's always going to produce a horizontal line. And if x equaled a value, that would equal a, that would represent a vertical line. Very good. Anybody have any other questions?